Good morning, students. Our new chapter is HTML and CSS. So, in previous class, we had learned HTML programming languages, but now in new class, we have to use HTML with CSS. Okay? So, first question is, why we use a CSS when we are already using HTML for designing web pages? The answer of that question is, the HTML is a basically body or content of the web page, but CSS is the appearance of the web page. Like same web page in different styles, this goal is achieved by the CSS, that you can design a same HTML page in a different styles by using the CSS. So what is CSS? CSS is a style sheet which is used for the appearance of the web page, and HTML is the content of the web page. Okay. So when we are designing a website, our web pages are developed by a HTML and designed by a CSS. So the full form of CSS is cascading style sheet. So what is the basic syntax of CSS? Like we had already learned the basic syntax of HTML. So now what is the basic syntax of CSS? So the basic syntax of CSS is selector. First you have to define your selector, that in which HTML tag you are going to apply your CSS. So selector is the HTML tag, now curly bracket for defining the area of the CSS. Now property which you are going to apply on that tag, the CSS property basically that you are going to apply on the tag, that CSS property, then the value of that property. So you can write multiple properties inside the curly bracket by using the semicolon to end a particular property with value. Okay. So here we are using two properties, that is color and font size. Okay, and the value of color is red and the value of font size is 14 pixels. Now here are some examples given to apply the CSS property in the paragraph. So paragraph is displayed in red, aligned to center of the page. Horizontal rule color and thickness are set on the HR means horizontal rule. So by this CSS property, color and height of the HR will be changed. Now we are going to apply the CSS on the body. So color, background color. Color is the font color. Background color is the background color of the body. Background image is the background image of the body. Okay. So these are the three different type of CSS are given here, which are applying on the P tag, HR tag, and body tag. Okay. Now, including CSS in HTML, you are able to include the CSS in HTML by the three different ways, that is inline style sheet, internal style sheet, and external style sheet. Okay. The format of CSS file is .css, like the format of HTML file is .html. So inline style sheet means you are inserting your CSS in line of tag when you are writing your HTML code. So that is the inline style sheet. So when you are using inline style sheet, you are going to add your CSS property in between the tags. Like here, the example is given, the image is given in which H1 tag is using, and in this H1 tag, you are defining your style property by using style equals to inverted comma font size colon 12 pixel semicolon font width colon bold semicolon color colon bold semicolon and inverted comma close. So this is the example of inline style sheet. Okay, in a line, in particular line. So wherever you want to insert your inline style sheet, you have to define in the particular line of that HTML code. Now second is internal style sheet. Internal style sheet means you are defining the style sheet inside the HTML code, but not in the line of the particular tag. So in the HTML code, there is a section is there, available there. That section is known as head section. Inside the head section, we are using title tag. So after completing the title tag, you have to start a new section, that is the style tag. So head, style, type equals to text CSS. Now you have to define your CSS. Now close the style, now close the head. Okay. So this is the image is given for this, so you have to write your CSS like this in the internal style sheet. So thus inline and internal are inside the HTML file. Okay, the inline CSS and the internal CSS are in the HTML file basically, but the external CSS is the externally available from the HTML file. Means it is outside from the HTML file. You are using that file outside from the HTML file. So for using the inline style sheet, you have to use this kind of thing, like wait a second. This kind of code you have to use, that is in external style sheet. External style sheet is separate file saved with the extension .css. You have to define your CSS file separately and save that CSS file using .css. Okay, all CSS properties, all CSS code is written in the CSS file, and in HTML file you have to write this code. This code you have to write in the HTML file, and the name of your CSS file is going to write here. Okay, the CSS file that you are saved from a particular name, you have to call that CSS file here by using this name in the HTML file. This is the code of the HTML file, and the CSS code you have written in the different file, that name maybe is style1.css. okay, so this is the external style sheet. Now CSS selector. CSS selector means you have different selectors to apply the CSS property. Like in the first slide we had seen the tag selector, basically element selector. In tag selector, the particular element has selected to apply the CSS property. So this is the element selector. Okay, CSS selectors are of three types: element selector, class selector, ID selector. ID selector means you have to define the particular ID inside the HTML tag, and by that ID, using the hash symbol, you can apply the CSS. And the class selector is you have to define the class, and now that particular class you have to use by using the dot symbol. Okay, so ID selector use hash, and class selector using dot. Okay, these are the different selectors are there. Okay, now next is CSS background property. How you can apply the background in using CSS in your HTML. So background properties have different properties: background color, background image, background position, background repeat. So background color means you have to apply a particular color on the background. Background image means you are putting an image in the background of the body. The related tag, related property of the background image is background repeat. If the image is very small and it is not taking the full part of your document, so you can use the repeat property. Like some images are very big, so you have to use background repeat with no repeat value, and when you want to repeat, so you have to use the value repeat, x repeat or y repeat. Background position is right on top. Background position is right on top. Background position is the position in which you can want to. So background position is the particular values from where your image is going to set in the background. So the right and top. Here the four position is given: bottom, right, top, left. So you have to apply at least two values to put your image properly from the corner of the page. Okay. Next is CSS text properties. Here you have the text properties to apply the proper properties on the text. So like if you want to color the text, you can use the color properties. If you want to use the text align, so you can align the text right, center, justify, left. Text decoration, you can decorate the text by underline, bold, italic. You can transform the text by capitalize, small letters, capital letters, sentence case, different cases are there. Text indent, 50 pixel. So the indentation is given, like some space is given to the paragraph of the tag, paragraph of the text, like indentation we are giving in the MS Word to make space while starting the paragraph. That type of indentation we can able to give here also. Okay. Next is CSS font. How can you change the font type, font weight? Here is the font properties is given, like font style. Style means italic, bold, underline. Font weight, bold. Font weight 900. It also makes font bold. Font family. Font style, italic, underline. Font family, Times New Roman. You have to write the family name or the font name that you are going to use in your text. Okay, in the HTML file, to make your HTML file very much prettier and different from other web pages. So you can change the font, see font family of that text also. Okay. So currently we are using HTML5. That is the latest standard for HTML, used to deliver rich multimedia content without plugins, support on multiple platforms, PC, tablet, smartphone, smart TV. Major browser supports HTML5. HTML5 also have different things, which is good than the previous HTML language or the HTML family basically. So we have to learn the CSS that is covered in this chapter. That is the what are the selectors of the CSS, how you can use CSS in your files, what are the properties of the CSS, what are the values of that properties. So this much you have to learn in this chapter. Okay.